talk of the Arlington National Cemetery. Children and grandchildren, your gramps, so sorry for your loss. I'm so glad you could be here today. Friends, family. It's an honor for us to be here as the Air Force family because he was one of our brothers. We honor him and we thank him for his service. Lieutenant Colonel Bowman deserves what he's getting today. He is a hero. He is a patriot for all that he did, all that he sacrificed during that very contentious time in our nation, serving over there in Vietnam and ultimately dealing with the effects of that. But we want to remember his life and his legacy. What he left for you. You have wonderful stories of him. You also have a legacy. What I mean by legacy is how you are different. Because he lived a wonderful life. Continue with some committal words of scripture and prayer, and as I do, just continue to lift up Robert in your own minds and hearts. Our Lord said that I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me, though he dies, yet shall he live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. Jesus also said, do not let your hearts be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many rooms. If it were not so, would I have told you that I'm going there to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I'll come back and take you to be with me where I am. Well, one of his disciples said, well, Lord, we don't know the way. And Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. Would you bow your heads with me in prayer? Almighty God, we commend to you the soul of one of your dear children, Robert Bowman. We commit his body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, and dust to dust, in the sure and certain hope of the resurrection unto eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose coming in glorious majesty to judge the world, the earth, and the sea, and the corruptible bodies of those who sleep in him shall be changed and made like his own glorious body, according to your mighty works. Amen. Amen. The Apostle Paul said, therefore we do not lose heart, though outwardly we are wasting away, yet inwardly we are being renewed day by day, for our light and momentary troubles are achieving for us an eternal glory that far outweighs them all. So we fix our eyes not on what is seen, but on what is unseen. Since what is seen is temporary, but what is unseen is eternal. Would you join me in the Lord's Prayer? Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. The power and the glory forever. Almighty God, Robert has finished his course now here on earth, and may he rest from his labors. Grant to all of us who are still on our pilgrimage, who walk as yet by faith, that having served you, we may be joined with him through our Lord Jesus Christ. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord. Let perpetual light shine upon him. May he rest in peace. May his soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of Almighty God, rest in peace. Amen and amen. Brothers and sisters, you recognize that flag being held in front of you. It's that flag of our nation, the United States of America. That is the flag that Lieutenant Colonel Bowman honored throughout his life, throughout his career. So it's fitting that today that flag is held.
I have slipped the surly bonds of earth, and danced the skies on laughter-silvered wings. Sunward I've climbed, and joined the tumbling mirth of sun-split clouds, and done 100 things you have not dreamed of. Wheeled and soared and swung high in the sunlit silence. Hovering there, I've chased the shouting wind along, and flung my eager craft through footless halls of air. Up, up the long, delirious, burning blue, I've topped the windswept heights with easy grace, whenever lark or even eagle flew. And while with silent lifting mind I've trod the high untrespassed sanctity of space, put out my hand and touched the face of God.